Welcome to Queenstown Arena. We got ourselves a hot one tonight. We got the battle between the North and the South. The old story we've all heard before. I'm Dave Dubnik, and I have a special guest. Welcome back, Aaron. It's wonderful to see. We've missed you this season. Tonight, all-star action. Aaron, tell us what you know.
Well, the first thing, Dave, is I retire like all NZIHL players retire. You know, they retire and they come back. That's me. But what do we know? We're playing for the glass shield tonight. You know, at the moment it's tied 3-3 between the two teams, so tonight that's for all the marbles.
Right. Just to explain, this is only domestic players playing in this, and where they started skating is the team that they are representing. So although you may see some players that are now playing on the North Island at the moment, but if they started in the South Island, that's the team they're on. So it's always an interesting combination of players.
A great example of that is Ian Wanamaker, who plays for the South Island, that played all of his NZIHL hockey in the Swarm, but he did start playing club hockey in Dunedin. So what do we got there? We got goalies in there. We got Rick Parry, I mean, perennial favourite Rick Parry up north. Spent a few years down south playing for the Thunder. This season he's been playing for the Admirals. And Michael Hopkinson from the Swarm.
Well and truly seasoned goaltending.
So we've got Andrew Hay, obviously the captain of the Swarm. Jamie Lawrence, number 2. This year he was doing their commute with the Red Devils. Remy Sandoy, number 8. Gareth McLeish, number 14. Thomas Heather, 21. Blake Jackson, you might recognise him from the opening shots. He's the guy with the gap in the teeth that skates up to the camera. Robin Vortanov, number 12. Aaron Henderson in 7. Michael Atwell, 18. Jeremy Chai, number 10. Jordan Chalice, number 22. I heard he got a bit of special attention last night in the Ice Blacks versus Stampede game. Braden Lee just made sure he knew that he was on the ice. Sean Harrison, number 16. Kyle Johnson, number 9. Taylor Rooney, number 19. And Nick Craig, number 3.
Rolling on to the South, we have Justin Finley, number 20 in goal, as well as number 1, Matt Schwartz. Old Schwartzy. Also in the defense?
Bert Haynes, number 2. Mitchell Freer, number 16. Thomas Tappan, number 21. Ian Wanamaker, who I was talking about before, the guy that sort of played all of his NZIHL career in the Swarm, playing for the South. George Coslett, number 22. Cameron True, number 8. Hayden Argyle, number 9. So we got both captains from the final last week in the same team. So it'll be interesting to see who takes the reins here. Chris Eden, number 7. Jackson Lane, number 12, Paris Hyde, number 19, Luke Pickering, number 4, Joe Orr, number 3, Bradley Apps, who's done 3 seasons jumping back and forth with the Red Devils, then the Thunder, then the Red Devils, Max McCarg, number 17, Harrison McCarg, number 5, Lachlan Freer, number 10, and Callum Burns, number 14.
All right, this is it. It's going to be a hot one tonight. You know, as you were going through that list of the South Island there, and I noticed that the last, we've got Cullum, Lachlan, Harrison, Max, actual, not only Stampede players, but actual Queenstown boys from Wachtip High School. Fantastic. Luke Pickering as well. Mitchell sure. Freer. I mean, my goodness, Wachtip High has turned out a huge collection of hockey players.
You're always going about that.
I know.
Do they come out of your woodwork class?
Yeah, they might have come out of the woodwork class.
But even making hockey sticks down there, or
forget about education. Play hockey. That's the way. Next week, remembering that the high schools is on in Dunedin, South Island High Schools.
All right, play is underway. North Island wins the draw initially. You have to excuse me, we don't have nameplates. I'm just going off the numbers. Paris Hyde picks it up. Passes across ice to Cameron True. Tries to sneak it through there to Paris. Hopkinson having to make an early save.
Early pressure there. It was a great little push through. Fantastic cover up.
So we've got referee Braden O'Loughlin and the lines up. And Michael Hopkinson in there. North Island win the draw again. So North Island the face-off winners so far. But South Island with the early pressure. Puck there with Sean Harrison playing his hockey out of Dunedin. Dumps it in. Just lets Finlay get a bit of a touch of the puck there. Finlay drops it off for Mitchell Freer. Passes up ice. Find number 7 there for the Southern team. Skates it in. Passes it across now. Number 14 with the puck. Callum Burns behind the net. Eden into the corner. Fight there for the puck in the corner. Callum Burns puts it out front. Luke Pickering turns, tries to shoot. Another save there by Michael Hopkinson.
Bit of clutter in front of the net. I noticed Bert Haynes hammering back, beaver tailing on that back point. He was wide open waiting for that pass. You got to remember that, you know, these guys haven't played together, although there are seven Stampede players on the South Island team. They haven't played together in this mix.
So for the third time, the North Island wins that face-off. They've got some good senders in that North Island team, Dave. Puck passed up ice, kept in there, though, by the South team. Puck passed around behind the boards. Gareth McLeish sends it up ice. Picked up there by Luke Pickering. Passes it back to Bert Haynes. Haynes just skates it out, turns, pass across ice to Hayden Argyle, captain to captain from last week's final. They're forming a pretty powerful D pairing. Who takes control there? Both have a lot to say. Nice big shot in there. Finlay just covers up.
Long shot, wide, good body stave by Finlay.
It's interesting about Finlay that we were talking about before. He hasn't played any NZIHL hockey for 2 months.
Yes.
It's interesting to see how he goes in this game, because the level is a lot higher than anything else you can find in New Zealand.
You got to also remember the characteristics of this Queenstown ice arena. We'll talk about those more.
South with the puck, cut under control by Wanamaker. Shot there by the North. Picked up there by number 22, George Koslett. Good hit here by the North. Finlay with the puck. Looks to play it up ice. Can't quite pick it up. Bounces off the pudge. Picked up there by number 17, Max McCarg. Max McCarg there puts it in front. Shot, not quite, hit the post. Nice, big long shot there by Mitchell Freer. George Koslett, sorry. Down in that corner, the blind corner that we have in Queenstown here. Big shot there by M. Wanamaker. Good save there by Michael Hopkinson. Now the North will skate it out. Kept in there by number 17 for the South, Max McCard. South certainly having the early running of this game. Harrison McCard there. Fancy footwork on the ice. I saw a lot of fancy footwork from him after the final last week. Some nice dance moves. Now the puck behind the net there for the South. Looking for some options. Bradley Apps dumps it back round. Skating in hard there for the South is Cameron True. Puck dropped off. Long period of play here, no whistle. 16, Sean Harrison picks up the puck, tries to clear it. South doing a good job of keeping it in the North half. 13 for the North now. Andrew Hay, captain, passes up ice, number 2. Shot. Another save by Hopkinson. Hopkinson making do a lot of work early on. Passed across ice, picked up there. Intercepted by number 14, Callum Burns. Burns there. Nice little step, moves across ice. Goes it in. Got two North players on him. Manages to get a pass across though to Joe Orr. Now the North with an opportunity. Leaves it there for Paris Hyde. The North are going to want to clean up things back there, I'm sure. Coach Andreas Kaiser will have a few things to say. Now the North's going to skate it out through number 7, Aaron Henderson. Dumped in. A really long period of play here now. I think we've had about 3 minutes without a whistle, though. Now Aaron Henderson with the puck, puts in a long shot. Just put it nicely in there by Justin Finlay. Bert Haynes picks up the puck. Haynes is going to skate it out. Passes up ice. Finds the number 4. Luke Pickering shot, just wide. Haynes, back to Pickering. Dropped off there, picked up there by number 10, Jeremy Chai for the North. Passes it back to Blake Jackson. Jackson looks for McLeish and the puck goes out of...
They found their whistle. They found the whistle and they finally blew it. That must have been 147 minutes of non-stop play, it felt like. They had a couple line changes in that on the fly. Great pressure. Some fantastic saves by Hopkinson and Finlay also making some good saves. Face off deep in that zone.
Shot there. Didn't get all the way through. South still with the puck. Now the North have it. South breakaway again. Harrison Max McCarg with the puck. Manages to keep it in. No. Now the North have an opportunity. Max McCarg there. I think we've got a delayed penalty. Fair enough to interference called on Max McCarg, and that was...
To be fair to Max, I'm not sure who it was that was breaking out. Had he got past Max, it would have been a huge opportunity there. So I never like to think it's a good penalty, but it was perhaps the only move.
I think it looked like Robin Bortonov, and you're right. He was breaking out, and he had another guy with him coming down that left flank.
Yeah.
So North Island with a good power play opportunity, first of the game. Kept in there. Jordan Chalice with the puck. Chalice passes it across ice. Andrew Hay. Looks for his options. Number two, shot. Save by Finlay. Jamie Lawrence keeping it in. Picked up by Mitchell Freer, trying to dump it in. Henderson to Chalice. Chalice across ice to Atwell. Atwell with the backhanded shot. Saved by Finlay. Now back to number Henderson. Chalice. Chalice across to Hay. Hay shoots. Scores!
Five hole.
So after all of that play by the South in that end, that first penalty,
yep.
North National capitalized.
I've said this more than once. You don't score goals by being in the box. And I have a bad feeling that Finlay was screened on that. In saying that, the North had a fantastic cycling and great passing in that. It was just a matter of time, I think. Both teams, I think, just trying to find their feet with their teammates. We've got, like I said, 7 Stampede players and probably 9 ex-Queenstown people. So they should be able to set things up for the South. We'll see how they go.
So puck in there for the South. So back to even strength after that goal. Deep in the net. Puck come out with Haynes. Haynes shoots. I'm not sure if it got all the way through to Hopkinson, but it definitely got stopped before it got to the net. Jeremy Chai passes up ice. Good tip in there by Sandoy. Number 7. Good hit there by Hayden Argyle. Just bumping Aaron Henderson off the puck. Up there. Shoot. Nice save by Michael Hopkinson. Out in front. Shot. Saved by Callum Burns. Finn Hopkinson thought he had it in his glove there for a minute, but it didn't quite hold on to it. Haynes just chips it ahead. Burns with the puck. Burns drops it off there. Shot there by Argyle. Saved by Hopkinson. He holds on the stick.
Great cover up there. Yeah, goalie's being tested. Great opportunity. You know, you said it earlier. The South have had a lot of pressure on the North, working them hard. But just that one little flurry. Although in a power play, is all it takes to put the North ahead.
There's a wee stat for you, Dave. Last time I played, Michael Hopkinson only had 2 shots the whole period he played. I think he's probably had more than that now.
definitely. There's some great flurries of activity happening in that once again. Challenged and covered up.
So you're talking about if they've had any chance. When I played, we used to have a session in the morning just to get some lines together. I'm not sure if they still do it here.
Big practicing, yeah. I wasn't here for that, no. Huge pressure in that.
Puck comes out, shot by Mitchell Freer. Deflection there, that's always dangerous as a goaltender. And Wanamaker. Back to George Coslett. Harrison McCarg looks for someone across the ice, can't find him. Picked up by Lachlan Freer though. Lachlan Freer keeps it in there. Ringed around the boards there by Blake Jackson. Picked up by the North, cleared. Skate back there, George Coslett. Now we've got that hybrid icing, so no icing there. George Coslett's going to just drop it off almost into his own net. And Mitchell Freer. It's a dangerous drop there. Mitchell Freer looking for options. Passes up ice to Paris High. Paris High manages to get past 1, 2. Passes off to Chris Eden. The Paris High and Chris Eden were a great combination together when they were playing at the Red Devils.
Amazing combination last night as well.
Atwell with the puck. Atwell skated in. Dumps it around. Picked up there by Mitchell Freer. Now the South try and get it out. Kept in there by Henderson. Jamie Lawrence, sorry. Shot there by Ellis, just deflected wide there. Kept in there by the North again. Sean Harrison Sean Harrison, probably not the most famous of his hockey siblings. Grace Harrison, of course, is the starting goaltender for the Ice Ferns. Jeremy Chai now just with the puck, just slow things down from the north. After that early pressure, the north have really regrouped well. As I say that, Paris Hyde picks it off, takes it into the corner. Hyde just keeping it into the corner. Eden will go pick it up. Now puck for Chalice. Pass across to Sandoy. Sandoy with the puck. Sandoy skates it in, drops it off for Chai. Chai picks up now. Chai with the shot. Good defense by Bert Haynes.
The old pick play there.
Oh, pick and roll.
Yes, well done.
Apps.
Sandoy.
Argyle to Haynes. Haynes in there deep. Can't quite get a shot off though. Funny angle. Now the rest of the support turns up. Puck goes to the north. Managed to clear it. Now puck comes back here for Callum Burns. Dumps it in. Looking for an icing call.
Yeah, some funny funny anomalies here. If you remember last night, the brothers were playing opposite each other. The Freers, Lockie and Mitchell, playing opposite each other. And as were the McCoggs. So and tonight they're playing together. It's, you know, what a fraternity we have. Deep in southern zone.
Haynes tries to chip it past number 19 for the north. Taylor Rooney. Picked off there by number 3 for the south. Joe Orr. Now that makes me feel old, because I remember when I started playing hockey, Joe Orr, his head barely came above the board. You could see these little eyes peering at you. Now he's out there playing for the south team. Ian Wanamaker picks up the puck. Ian Wanamaker, good pressure there from the north through number 12. 13. 12, Robin Vortinov. He's one of those players that tucks his jersey into the back of his shorts and makes commentators' life difficult.
No name badge and no number.
Big nice pick. Opportunity here for the north now. North skates it in, shot. Good save by Finlay. Good opportunity by Kyle Johnson. Just couldn't quite finish it off.
Hey. Yeah, you'd be seeing a lot of young, all these young and coming up, coming. Both North and South Islanders, you're right, they were just young skaters when you probably left the fraternity, and now they're active members of many of these teams.
Dumped in there for the North, picked off there by number 12 for the South. Number 12, Jackson Lane. Puck get tipped out, so we'll have a face-off inside. Yeah, that's right, Dave, yeah, like I said, little eyes sort of peering at you, can't quite see their whole face.
Yeah. I'm finding that as well when I play in my social leagues. These young guys used to boss them around, and now they're bossing us around, or bossing me around, and making me feel really old.
Chalice looking for the pass there, can't quite get it. We'll have an icing call. Yeah, no, like I was saying before about the Eden Paris combination, when they played together on the Red Devils, I think they had some ridiculous 120 points line. It was them and Ryan Ruddle. So it's Ryan Ruddle, Paris Hyde, and Chris Eden. Eden great. Had about 59 points that season. Paris Hyde had almost the same, and then Ruddle was about 30.
Great combination of great players.
Yeah, so they do well for the Ice Blacks, and they managed to get on the ice together. They seem to manage to not coordinate very well. Hopefully we'll see them together this season. True goes back for the putt, but we've already got an icing call.
Things have slowed down. There's kind of, I don't know if they've, the energy's lost or they've, but a couple icings there, and just not quite as accurate a passing as they had earlier in the period, which is unusual. Usually it becomes better. We're looking at 9 minutes, 9 seconds left in this 1-0 game for the North.
Shot there right out in front for Bradley Apps. Can't quite get it in though. Paris High puts in a shot. Hopkinson bobbles the puck again. That's not the first time he's done that here. Now a good opportunity for Chalice. Chalice comes in. Chalice skating in. He's got Atwell with him. Chalice shoots.
And just scores. Justin got most of that puck. You know, if it was a pie, he ate everything but the crust. But it just got through, I believe, his glove and just trickled in behind him. Unfortunate for...
That might have been one Andreas was shaving the sides off.
Yeah, I saw him earlier. Now, Bert Haynes is not happy with his result there. It was his puck that the, or his stick that the puck bounced over to allow that little breakaway. So that puts a 2-0.
To be fair to Justin Finlay, they had both players there. He had Atwell coming down the right, and he was sort of caught in two minds. And so he did well to get a piece of that puck.
Spectacular play by the North Island there. Chased that. But once again, huge pursuit activity in the North Island side, but they only had one chance, and they make it work. So that's all it takes.
They are finishing well at the moment.
Finishing well.
I do wonder if having 2 months, well, 2 months off not playing NZIHL hockey is a little bit to do it for Finlay. Like, it's hard to get back into hockey like that. I'm not sure if he's been playing club hockey up in Canterbury. Now Henderson with the puck, puts in a shot, bounces off the side of the net. Hayden Argyle now with the puck. Passes around to Bert Haynes. Haynes lets it go past for Burns. Burns drops it off to Luke Pickering. Pickering passes across ice to Joe Orr. Shot out in front. Hopkinson diving, scrambling.
Clutter in front of the net. One big schmozzle. And he didn't actually have possession of the puck. I don't know what the whistle was for, but perhaps he had it just long enough for the whistle.
I think Peter Haxel lost sight of it, and when the referee loses sight, he's got it to stay. Yeah. And I've been involved in games where the goalie doesn't have it, but because the referee can't see it, he's just got to say, I don't know where it is, so that's what it is. We'll stop it.
My goodness, I was going to comment earlier. There is that's about the seventh shot on
Hopkinson
within the last minute, and he's like one of those ducks in a carnival where he gets and he's doing a great job of blocking them all.
Kept in there well by the South, Ian Wanamaker. Lachlan Freer with the puck. Drops it off to Harrison McCard. In the blind corner now, got a little bit of play. Puck's going to come out here for Lachlan Freer.
Yes, you got both McCogs out there at the moment. Harrison with the puck.
Harrison puts it in front.
Max was sitting there waiting for us.
North Island's looking for that stretch pass a lot. They're coming out of the ice and looking for that pass across. Going into the corner again. Number 22, George Kosser, puts it in front. North's going to skate it out. Pass across. They're going to chase in. Pressure there by number 9, Kyle Johnson. Chris Eden now with the puck. Eden passes up ice to Bradley Apps. Apps to Harris Hyde. Eden shoots. Takes a deflection off a foot there, and the North can clear. Back to Mitchell Freer. Freer drops it in. Harris Hyde tried to stop it there, couldn't do so. Now we've got a nice wee break here for number 19, Taylor Rooney. Rooney, play, nice play. Sorry, not Rooney. 18, Michael Atwell. Atwell drops it off to Sean Harrison. Harrison can't get past Mitchell Freer. Mitchell Freer and Sean Harrison, teammates last year for the Thunder. Nice backhanded shot there, just sort of bobbled in though. Didn't have enough pace on it to make it all the way to the net. Puck sitting there. No one's going to take ownership of that puck there, just sitting there. Mitchell Freer now with it, chipped out of the boards. Nice play. Eden now going to pick up the puck in the corner. Eden with the puck. It's going to get dumped the whole way down. Just the South just lose, not quite got all of the cogs working together at the moment. They're getting down there, but just not pulling that final trigger.
Absolutely right. That tape-to-tape is missing. Tape-to-tape passes, buddies.
Now Jeremy Chai with the putt. Chai shoots. Nice save there by Finlay. Sort of worked those cobwebs off now, Finlay. Yeah.
Big rebound available for anyone that wanted it, but it was cleared down the ice nicely.
You know what I liked about that rebound? It was a big rebound, but it was big enough. If you have a wee rebound that sort of comes out in front of you, it's dangerous, but if you get it big enough, it goes past the attackers that are coming in.
The deep slot players.
Jeremy Sandoy now with the puck. Sandoy, we've got linesman down, Brandon O'Loughlin down, Jeremy Chai with the puck. Chai tries to drop it off, but Jeremy Sandoy can't do so. Bert Haynes passes up ice to Callum Burns. Callum Burns looking for Luke Pickering, can't quite pick him up though. Blake Jackson. Now we've got a slashing pull.
Callum. Oh, young Cullen Burns. A little bit of retaliation on that hit. And, ended up in the box. 2 minutes for a slash.
Yeah, the referee always seems to see the retaliation.
I know. It was, well, I didn't see anything wrong with the hit, but I was just mentioning earlier that Max McCaug, Harrison McCaug combination, wouldn't that make Mama and Dad proud? Yeah. Goal out of those two boys.
Does the sister play ice hockey? Does Ellie play ice hockey?
Ellie, yeah, she's still playing in Dunedin.
Puck goes in deep. Held in there by the South. Now it's coming out for the North. Pass across ice by Sean Harrison. Sorry, not Sean Harrison, Bortonov. Bortonov with the puck. Bortonov drops it off. Shot from deep. Thomas Tapp in there with the puck now. Cleared by Harrison McCarg. Big hit there in the side on the boards there. Now the puck comes out for the South. Harris Hyde with it. Harris Hyde with the puck. Harris passes across ice to Thomas Tappan. Sends it down. Picked up by Atwell. Atwell looking for a passing opportunity. Picked off there by Harris Hyde. Cameron True there with a nice check. Michael Atwell. Passes across ice. Andrew Hay passes back to number two. Jamie Lawrence. Lawrence with the puck. Lawrence passes across ice. Shot there. One of those dangerous bobbling pucks. Atwell. Atwell behind the net to number 16. Sean Harrison. Harrison now tries to bring it out in front. North have got nice use of this power play again. North has got a really good power play unit for a team that doesn't play well, played a lot together. Although I do notice a lot of Swarm players on it. Chalice shot. Goal.
Sniperville. Once again, that inside post left unguarded. I wonder again if he was a little bit screened. There's a little bit of mess in front of the net that needed to be cleared out, but well done. Oh, my goodness.
Now that I look at that power play line, I was wondering why they're working so well together. I think on that power play line, there's only one player that doesn't play for the Swarm. So it's probably right. A traditional
yes.
Power play unit. Because they looked a bit too crisp and clean for one that's come together.
Well organized, seasons, we would say.
So score 3-0 to the North Island. When I played here last time, we lost 3-2 overall. Then Queenstown tends to be a lower scoring out of all of the State of Origin games. So the South will be hoping to get on the board soon. We've seen some big scores in these games before, though.
tests for goaltenders.
Yeah, I remember not liking playing in these sort of games. I think to the point you had before, because the teams aren't in combination together, the defense gets a bit loose.
Yeah, just there's something to be said about just the knitting of a team.
Jeremy Chai with the puck, passes across ice. Henderson. Sandoy shoots.
Scores.
Does that take a bounce?
No, I think it just outside post. I wonder if we'll see Finley taking a break, perhaps, putting Schwartzy in the post.
Bring in Schwartzy, a crowd favorite here.
Yes.
Wasn't it great scenes watching Schwartzy carry that cup around? He got a big cheer.
He's an old warhorse from the start of this whole league. And he's been standing in and backing up and standing in and backing up for years. So, it'll be nice to see him get in there. We're looking at a 4-0 game for the North at 2 minutes and 21 seconds left in this first period.
Puck goes in there deep with the South. Yeah, the South have had a lot of opportunity and time in that end. They just can't quite find the back of the net.
Yeah, I would... sort of a disorganized time there. They're not cycling well. They're spending time in there, but they're not actually getting those passes complete.
Well, two of the North goals were on the power play as well. We haven't seen the South. Shot. Big two-pad stack. We haven't seen a two-pad stack since the 1980s, 70s.
Yeah.
When you were playing hockey, maybe, Dave, we saw a two-pad stack.
Yeah, that was back in my day. That was a spectacular save. And with that low ceiling, that huge bounce it took, had it not hit the ceiling, we had a higher roof. That puck would have been still an interesting play as goaltender was sort of out of action trying to get back up.
Yeah, we might have to talk to Ted and Dave, Dan about
raising
the roof.
Yeah, especially after last weekend. If that crowd didn't raise the roof last weekend, I don't think it could be done. It was crazy in here last
weekend.
Well,
I've heard Ted and Dan have got some nice plans, some glass next year.
Amazing plans. This place is going to be swishy mo next year. Glass, boards, and ice.
It's quite an important factor. Puck behind the net there.
Puck bobbling around behind that net. Nobody claiming it. Battling for it in that corner. Holding, waiting for the ref. Ref's not blowing the whistle, can't find the whistle. No. They're holding.
Still holding. Yeah, Apps manages to get it out. No, number 16 for the North Island. Still got his foot on it, Sean Harrison. Now it comes out for the North. North with an opportunity here. Atwell with the puck. Atwell shoots, hits the post and the roof.
Bangs and off that top crossbar. That was glorious. Haven't seen one of those either for a long time. So he had beaten Finlay. Yeah. And it just a little bit too high. Once again, all the activity in that north. One little break down to the south.
Dave's, of course, talking about the teams. We're not sure if that would actually the compass directions we're standing on.
Sorry.
Puck now with Joe Orr. Orr into the corner.
I was just laughing at the referee, the group of referees in the corner.
Bert Haynes now off the puck. Look to start something. The South probably want to try and get a goal on the board before the break.
With only 50 seconds left, they've got to push hard.
Pickering with a shot.
Still keeping it in.
Argyle now. Argyle puts it out in front. Just can't quite. Luke Pickering not with his stick on the ice. That'll make Don Cherry very mad. He always goes, keep your sticks on the ice, kids.
Only 25 seconds left in this first period. South still keeping it in. But
shot.
Again.
Blocked there by the D. Now Remy. Remy's going to drop it off for Jeremy Chai. Chai tries to get it past Argyle. Can't do so. It's very hard to get past Argyle. He is a bit of a human brick wall. Haynes with the puck. Drops it off for Eden. Eden now. Eden dumps it in deep. Bounces. Comes out in front. Funny netting from the... in the Queenstown Arena.
Yes, another funny characteristic about the Queenstown Arena, the net behind them.
So that's the end of the first period, Dave. What do you see?
I'm seeing that an awful lot of action happening in the North Island zone, but nothing crisp. You used the word crisp, and that was spectacular. Those goals were crisp goals that were scored on the South Island. So lots of action happening in the North, but when the North get it into the South zone, they actually get it with purpose. Two penalties, that doesn't happen.
Yeah, so the score's 4-0, and two of those were power play goals. So South will want to try and keep it out of the bench and maybe hope that they can draw a penalty and see what they can do with their power play unit.
Yes.
Because like, we looked at the teams before, there's like a very dominant Thunder Stampede flavor to the South team. So if we get onto the power play, I'm sure they can put together some old combinations or guys that have sort of played together and have that sort of
definitely they'd be able to work together, get themselves out of full stampede or full thunder line on that, just to work together. Well, I'm Dave Dubnik.
I'm Aaron Bryan.
We'll see you in a moment for the second period. Welcome back to the second period. Here we are, Queenstown Arena. We've got the skate of origin, North against the South, the old story. Second period, 4-0. I'm Dave Dubnik.
I'm Aaron Bryant.
Aaron, how do you dig yourself out of a 4-0 deficit?
The first thing they've done, the South have done, is they've switched goalies, Justin Finlay to Matt Schwartz. That's not necessarily, and what I mean by that, it's not necessarily a slight on Finlay, but just to change the dynamic for the team. The team says, look, we've changed our goalie, we've got to do some more, we're going to help protect that guy out the back.
Definitely. Wow. They're going to have to bust out hard. I'm betting that coach spoke to that South Island, said, listen, boys, we need a goal early in this piece just to get the momentum back on our side. We'll see how we go.
Yeah, that's right, Dave. We definitely want some early goals here. Dumped in there deep by the South. Picked up there by Lawrence. Lawrence rims it around to Harrison. Picked up there by Eden. Back there by True. Cameron True with the puck. Stays behind the giant Eagles net. Just for those at home, the South of the Giant Eagles, and I think the North called the Whiptails or Stingrays, depending on where you're from. Puck there for Eden. Sorry, Paris Hyde shoots. Chalice picks up the rebound. Chalice skates it out. Skates into, dumps it into the zone. Puck comes out in front. Mitchell Freer with the puck. Freer now passes up ice. Finds Apps. Apps tries to find Eden, can't do so, and we'll have an icing pull.
That shot on
Michael Hopkinson.
Michael Hopkinson was a great shot, but it was a huge rebound. South Island didn't have any trailers there to pick that up because he was down, and he had that big top corner open. So well done to the North Island early in this piece.
Cut close there to the North. Shot. Saved by Matt Schwartz.
Oh, Schwartz, he's being tested early in this piece. Great cover-up.
Schwartz, a crowd favorite here in Queenstown.
Oh, he would be, yes. I just want to be a big thanks to all you viewers out there that couldn't get tickets to this game. Huge thanks to you locally, and we'll carry on in a minute.
Shot there just wide. Argyle tries to clear the zone, can't do so. Puck kept in. Passed around the net. Haynes back to Argyle. Argyle to Haynes. Haynes can't control it though. Just going over that Luke Pickering. Picked up there by Gareth McLeish. Almost taken out there by one of his own players. Took the high stick there. I don't know if you can get a high stick called on your own team, can you, Dave?
If you draw blood, I guess you could. I don't know. That would be a good question for the refs.
That should be our next segment of the period break. Ask the ref. Haynes here with the puck. Jeremy Chai. Chai skates it in, puts on a shot. Is it off the post?
Yes, I heard metal. A little bit of a bell ringer there. And darn it. Anyway, we've got that Hayden with a penalty.
So we're talking about the goalie. I'm not quite sure what the South can do in terms of the players themselves. I guess just a bit more accurate with the shooting. Following up on those rebounds.
Yeah, shot. They're passing, you know, in once they're in that north zone. They had a lot of time in their last period, but their passing was not quite crisp enough to get a good position for a shot on net.
There's a goal.
Yeah, it
just
was.
Sort of snuck through there.
Yes.
So Schwartz went out to grab it and just sort of slid through.
Yeah, whether it was Polk.
I didn't actually catch the score on that one.
Oh, we'll get that in a moment. So that puts a 5-0 game in the second period, early in the second. 18:04 left in this second period.
I can't remember exactly who it was, but LA Kings were definitely the opponents, but I remember there was an NHL game where they came down from 5-0 to win it in the third, so it's not impossible or not achievable.
No, I you will see a huge change once those connections start happening on that passing for the South Island. Huge change.
Hopkins is just going to cover up down there. Parasite just making sure that he's got a nice tight grip there, just just give you a wee poke there.
Yeah. Wasn't sure if he's going to sweep that away or actually keep it. I think he was in two minds there himself. Face off left of Hopkinson.
Picked in there by True. Picked around by Apps. High puts it in front there. Looking for Eden. Can't quite find him. Eden shoots. Takes a deflection. Apps tries to drop it off for Paris, but Paris is gone. Skated out here by Lawrence. Flipped up to Chalice. We're going to have a penalty, a delayed penalty here on Paris Hyde. Nice deflection by a True into the rafters.
Well, the seat in that box is not going to be getting cold.
Well, that's right. I'd hate to be the first North guy to get a penalty. That'd be ice cold.
Another unfortunate penalty for the South Island. These things do. They may even kill this penalty, but what it does is tire out your top line there.
So now North with another power play opportunity. Jeremy Chai skated it out. We've got an icicle. We've got a very attentive viewer, Claire Zogler, our friend from up in the North Island. She just told me it was the Flames versus the Blackhawks in 2009 where the Hawks came back to win after being down 5-0.
Where are you tonight, Claire? Fantastic. Good to hear from you.
Callum Burns clears the zone. Almost an opportunity there for Luke Pickering. Just couldn't quite control it. In the corner there for the North. Now got an opportunity coming this way. Callum Burns with the putt. Big roar from the crowd. Local boy drops it back behind him. You hardly know it was a penalty kill there with that rush from the South. Gareth McLeish picks off Remy's Sandoy on the blue line pretty nicely. Sandoy rings it around behind and picked up by Argyle. Argyle finds Haynes. Haynes can't quite clear the zone though. Haynes putting pressure on Blake Jackson. Blake Jackson drops it in deep. Up there by number 8, Remy Sandoy.
Argyle and Sandoy say hello to each other in front of the net.
Puck's coming out. Clear the zone by the South there. North will look for a change. Funny story about Sandoy wearing 8 tonight. I think he wanted 13, but Andrew Hay, being the senior player, managed to outrank him. I was in the change room earlier and they're having a big fight over that jersey.
Over who's going to wear what? Lucky numbers come into play.
Whiff on the shot there by the North, number 9. Kyle Johnson, now the puck comes back the other way. The South won't put on too much pressure. Hopkinson tries to clear the zone. Picked up there by Harrison McCarg. Harrison McCarg skates around 2. Unfortunately, just hits his skate and clears the zone.
Unlucky. That's that bull terrier action of Harrison McCarg, son of Richard McCarg, brother of Max McCarg.
We're going through the whole genealogy today.
The whole genealogy, yeah. Shot carried over to the corner. The North Island's struggling to get any sort of development on this power play.
So now we've got Gino
Hyde. It's back up, then, and now they're back to square numbers.
Harrison Max with a shot and goal!
That was Max. Richard, you better be watching that one. Excellent shot. Max McCarg firing it in. It wasn't a spectacularly hard shot, but obviously found that. Oh, ho, ho. That was great.
So as we just got told, Max McCarg was out there with brother Bull Terry Harrison McCarg, and we were right, Ellie McCarg did play for the Iceburns, and she's the only member of the McCarg family that has an NZIHF gold medal. So
yeah,
congratulations, Ellie.
Yeah, the boys will be working hard to change that, I'm sure. Fantastic. Now, you know, that changes momentum. Two things have happened here. Penalty kill with no goal and a goal scored. So, you know, North Island's struggling a little bit. Maybe they burnt their jets out.
As a South fan, I guess I'll be hoping for that.
Yeah, how can you tell what side I'm quietly cheering for? I'm supposed to be.
The other person will be upset with that is Michael Hopkinson, because last time he played in Queenstown, he actually got the shutout for his section of the game. So that goal ruins that. I don't have to say shutout now because it's no longer one.
Great save there, Swartzy.
Puck comes across the ice. Picked up there by Mitchell Freer. Mitchell Freer with the puck. Passes to
Bad Drew. Pass.
Picked up there by Chalice. Now we've got another delayed penalty.
Oh, well. I don't know. What do you think? South Island just like playing with 4 players.
I think I saw them install a hot chocolate machine in the penalty box before.
Yeah, cappuccino. Long black, please. Well, that goal scored by Max McCarg, that'll make Mama McCarg very, very happy. Lindsay McCarg was also a timekeeper in the officials' box there. So the whole family's heavily involved in hockey, much like many of our families here.
Puck bouncing around there. The North Remy Sandoy almost trying to bat it in with his glove. in deep there. Sandoy looking, fishing around for the stick. Puck comes out, Chai looking for the pass, and then Leash can't find it.
That point pass wasn't on the stick at all, ending up all the way back in the North Island zone.
Pass it out there from North Island, Aaron Henderson to Mick Leash. Remy Sandoy with it on the blue line. Only manages to find Chris Eden. Back to Sandoy though. Out front shot. Blocked there by the South. Yeah. Great goal by Remy Sandoy. Big rebound came back up. Sandoy's sitting there. Got open net to look at.
Little bit of a tic-tac-toe there. I think Schwartz, he didn't really have a chance on that one. That was, it was all over the place, making that beautiful first and second save. But yeah, I mean, you're down a player and he's getting peppered.
So that was Nick Craig that made that happen. He came in with that early first shot, and then it was Sandoy that managed to put it away. So again, so the power play for the Northern Whiptails is doing pretty well tonight, 3 from 4.
The Eagles got a boogie if they want to stay in this game. They're going to have to get another quick goal. We're looking at a 6-1 with 13 minutes, 32 seconds left in the big second period.
Puck just... Bert Haynes couldn't quite control the puck there and managed to put some pressure on the team. Skated out, picked up Argyle. Argyle can't control it. Now the puck comes back here for Burns. Burns tries to enter the zone. Good check there by Blake Jackson, just separating Burns from the puck. Now 19, Taylor Rooney goes into the corner. Big hit there by Hayden Argyle. No, the sort of hits that we expect.
Did you just say a big hit from Hayden Argyle? Does that surprise you? Hayden,
really.
I believe this might be his last game of his because he's announced his retirement. And so, you know, he's going to want to get all his money's worth this evening.
For the last bang for his buck here.
Yeah, big bangs for his buck.
I'm sure that North Island's looking forward to that. Big hit there by Bert Haynes. North Island with the puck, the shot, saved by Schwartzy.
Great testing of Schwartzy.
I've got a story about Hayden Argyle checking. I always played a goalie, so I never got to see it. But the story goes that if you ever see Hayden coming, which is very rare, the pupils in his eyes just dilate so big that it looks like he's just got these black eyes and he comes in and smacks it. So apparently it's like, you know, that's sort of
hint.
The last rites. You just see these eyes coming towards you. It's the last thing you remember.
As Hayden Argyle, the big hitter.
Paris Hyde with the puck. Paris Hyde skates it in, looks across ice for Eden. That one came through the rafters.
Yes, almost came through, almost made it past those rafters. Once again, I just wanted to thank those people viewing, Dunedin, Auckland, Christchurch. Big thank you for viewing tonight, and for people all around the world watching this game tonight, you know, probably spending a nice summer's evening somewhere watching hockey.
And thanks to the Winter Games for helping us out, getting a bit more advertising. And to Centre Ice for providing the jerseys and the uniforms and the hats and all the things that make the crowd look colourful. Kept in there by True. True shoots. Paris Hyde tries to put a deflection on, can't quite do so. Paris Hyde can't keep it in. So he'll just turn back on the zone there. Managed to lose the puck to Tyler Rooney. Rooney's doing quite well tonight. I haven't seen a lot of them play. And goal scored by Jordan Chalice. Turned a bit of a goal fest for the North Island here. What do you reckon, Dave?
Well, that was some great passing, some great shooting, and Schwartzy needs some backup there deep in that zone. It's going to have to happen in order for him to... He can make initial saves. And, we're down to... We're looking at a 7-1 game, and we're only halfway through this game.
Yeah, South are going to have to find something special.
That's right.
See a few guys floating around in the crowd. We might Cameron Frears over there, Gareth Lloyd.
Yes, pick on a few more. Yes, the Eagles must take flight. Max McCaug facing off, the only goal scorer for the South Island.
Now, did I just see a hat get thrown back?
Yeah.
Was that the hat trick?
Could have been. We'll check on that.
Back up ice to Harrison McCarg, finds Lachlan Freer. Freer with a shot, saved by Hopkinson, right in the bread basket.
Lockie's got quite a sniper eye, so he wasn't happy with the release on that shot, but great passing there from the McCarg. for Lachlan Freer.
I think Lachlan Freer may have won the hardest shot competition when we used to hold it a couple of years back for the State of Origin. They used to do some sort of skills and things. I believe Lachlan Freer, if he didn't win it, he was definitely in the top sort of section of those players.
Great work by Max McCogg to keep that puck in, battling against
North. Lachlan Freer dumps it in deep. Chased there by Harrison McCogg. Two brothers in. Max McCogg with a hit on Gareth McLeish. Long pass to Chai. Chai with a one-on-one breakaway. Saved by
Schwartzy. Pulls it off. And
it hit the roof, so we're going to have a stop.
Yes, quick stoppage of play. Face-off to the left of Matt Schwartz, deep in that southern zone, deep south.
Blake Jackson, the shot there goes wide. Chipped ahead by number 13. Puck ahead. Good attack there. Shot.
That's what Mama likes to see. Big rebound. I spoke about that rebound earlier, Aaron. Wonderful shot from Luke, I think it was. And then big rebound opportunity.
It's Joe Orr that managed to score that, put the puck in the back of the net.
Amazing. That was wonderful, and that turns things around, hopefully giving the South Island a little bit more gumption.
It might have been Jackson Lane with the first shot.
Oh, okay.
And then Joe Orr picked it up. So both, interestingly, both the goals have been picked up by some of the younger players for the South. We're not seeing the Edens or the Hyde scoring. We're seeing the McCargs and we're seeing the Orrs. Maybe that's what we need to do for the South. Get those youngsters out there.
I have to laugh after during that first time first intermission. Ryan Strayer and Matt Schneider out there just watching. They're probably hungry for action, but they've done their dash, and a big salute to those boys who have contributed well.
It's interesting you mention those imports, Dave, because I was standing in the foyer, and Stephen Reeb was there, and he was talking about how they sort of, he'd be interested in maybe having an all-star line in the State of Origin. So you keep it like the natural players, but you may have three players in the North and three in the South. That's a voted for thing. I thought that was quite a cool concept. You know, don't overwhelm the team with imports, but have a couple there, fan favorites, you know, your Matt Schneiders. The other thing, because we talk about imports a little bit, is I noticed Justin Daigle, who's an import for the Amos, is coaching the North, so they do give back.
Yes, definitely. I know locally they definitely give back, our local imports, helping out with those juniors and little guys.
So we've got Rick Parry in net now, so we've got to change the goalie.
Big
Rick
rebound again.
Save early on, net's off. No one seems to have noticed. Chris Eden with the puck. Eden can't control, puts it in front.
Pass in front. Wow.
Flexion
great off
skate there.
Bit of a flurry.
Mitchell Freer with a shot. Saved by Rick Parry. Rick's just going to cover it up. So this had a goalie change after that last goal.
Yeah. So that was a great little flurry by the South Island. North Island kind of caught on their back foot. Not able to clear it.
Well, I guess with the new goalie, that's what the South want to do. They want to put a lot of pressure on that new goalie. Don't let them settle. You've got 5 goal deficit to try and make up. You're really going to need as many goals as you can get. Specifically 5 to start with.
McCogg to McCogg in front.
Shot. Goal!
That was McCogg. McCogg to McCogg to Freer. Great combination.
That's a pretty Queenstown combination.
Yeah, that's right. Proud of those boys. Mama Freer, you'll be happy with that one.
So yeah, early on, Rick Parry's been in net for all of 20 seconds, 30 seconds, and the South put pressure on. And that's probably where they can make inroads. Get into that goalie early, before they've had time to settle. In saying that, Rick's been an Ice Blacks goalie for the last couple of years, so he's no mug. Now we've got McCarr coming in again. Shoots, love save by Rick Parry. Oh, a little, how are you going in front of the net there?
That shot.
Aaron Henderson and Lachlan.
Henderson and Lachlan Freer.
Just a bit of energy come back into that South team after that
last
goal.
I think somebody read the book and said, new goalie, keep the pressure on, keep the heat on. Line change is happening.
Jackson Lane takes the draw. This is it for number 12 for the North Island. Skates it in. Portnov. They've got a penalty.
Penalty. Well.
Slashing call.
I have a feeling it might be our friend Bert Haynes.
So just as we were getting a bit of energy back in the south and attacking the goal, we would take another penalty. So that would definitely help the north. Not that they need a lot of help right now, though.
No, no. Late change. Deep face off. Deep in that southern zone.
Cleared there by the south. Rick Parry will go back to play it. Good pressure put on here by Callum Burns. Just getting between Rick and his defender. Just making him play the puck there, not making him let him settle. It's good when players do that, I think. As long as you've got those wheels to get back onto that penalty kill, put that pressure on. Don't let them settle.
Yeah, no, once again, you know, young players having that extra energy, you know, like Callum, like McCaug, fantastic. That sort of tenacity that confused the older players that aren't used to having that pressure on them while they're trying to set up. You know, what are you doing back here? This is my spot. One in every five of those just could go your way.
Cut past the cross there to Chalice. Chalice will dump it in. Number 16 for the North will skate in deep. Sean Harrison. Harrison. Big hit there by Mitchell Freer onto Harrison. Mitchell Freer will clear it. Rick Parry will go out and play it once again. Luke Pickering this time with the pressure, but not as hard as Callum Burns. Just making sure that the North don't sit there. With a four-goal lead, they can afford to not waste a bit of time. Jeremy Chai skates it in. Drops it behind him to Jordan Chalice. Puck cleared there by Mitchell Freer. Tipped ahead by Luke Pickering. North Island, Henderson. Play broken up there by Chris Eden. Paris High putting pressure on now. Paris High just showing that veterans can put pressure on as well. Dave there just taking a check. Took it well, Dave. Puck clear.
Firing it down. North Island not getting any traction on this power play. Definitely. Oh, just about a big mistake.
Puck in there for Henderson. Henderson goes in deep. And on the boards, big hit.
I don't think we're in Kansas anymore, Toto. That was
Hayden Argoff. Hayden's like, oh, look like Bert Haynes, the captain of the Stampede's got a rest. I'm going to have one too.
Oh, my goodness. Just checking his chiclets, making sure that all his teeth are there.
Yeah. But we got the extra dental records on the side so we can compare.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah, that was just a hard hit. Maybe just a little bit of frustration there. I was just saying that the North Island was suffering for traction. They weren't getting any shots on Schwartzy during this penalty kill. There's only 8 seconds left in Burt's penalty. So I'm wondering with a blood drawn whether or not that'll be more
two
serious.
2+2, maybe. 5 minutes. The city. Well, here we go. Hayden Argoff gone.
Well, that's a tough way to, you know.
End the career.
Yeah.
So a 5 in game for Hayden Argoff.
Okay. Wow.
So I think they might have called check to the head there.
Oh, okay.
Apologies to the referees. That watching, won't be I missed the signal. Oh. Paris Hyde now with the puck. Paris decides to skate it in. Gets around one.
Choosing to skate it in with only 3. Burt's off the penalty box and on the ice.
That's not going to help the South cause having shorthanded for 4 minutes. I think we're going to see a bit more attack from them now.
From the north, you definitely.
I think the south, before we're trying to kill the penalty, but now you've got 5 minutes with a 4-goal deficit. You can't really sit back on it. You're just going to have to chance your arm and put a lot of pressure on.
Back yourself. Great pressure there.
Pressure by Hyde. Blake Jackson passes up ice to Henderson. Can't control it though. Wanamaker tries to pick it up, can't do so. Now the puck goes in for Vortnov. Shot goes wide. Mitchell Freer tries to clear, can't get all of it though. Now the puck goes ahead, picked up here by
McCard.
Mitchell Freer tries to drop it off for Max McCard, can't do so. Number two for the North, skating it in. Atwell. Lawrence with the puck. Lawrence puts it out into the corner. Chalice swings it around the boards. And managed to be cleared there by the South, number 17, Max McCarg. Rick Perry will just leave it behind there for Lawrence. Lawrence looks up ice. Passes it across to Andrew Hay. Andrew Hay putting on a set of wheels. Out there. Puck over to Haynes. Chris Eden. Dumps it ahead. Max McCarg skating after it. Bit of a tussle behind the play here. It was over pretty quickly though.
No arms are up, so play on.
Gareth McLeish, Jordan Chalice. Chai shoots wide. Now we've got Eden with the puck. Eden will just hold up the puck play here. Eden looks up ice, swings it around the boards. Perry will come out and stop it, leaves it behind for McLeish. McLeish passes up ice, tip on that.
See that forced play by Harrison McCaug actually make a bad pass, so that all works. And there's that pit bull terrier action, and a hit, and he's hurt. He's quite hurt, but no penalty, so.
Play will stop. I think it might be a leg or a knee.
Not sure. Harrison McCaug, Richard, what the heck your son's doing tonight? He's all over the ice.
And that's Gareth McLeish down there. I hope he's okay.
Just looks like a leg, I think.
You don't like to see injuries in these sort of games. At the physio heading out there. Now that shot before by Bert Haynes, they tell you to make shots from the blue line. I think he took the wrong blue line.
Yeah, you know, the point, but the wrong point. Yeah, no, that was a long shot.
But yeah, what was good about that shot was that long shot was chased up by Harrison McCard. They didn't let that drift. They went in and they chased, they attacked the rebound.
Attacking and created that attacking even with only four players. So we're looking at 2 minutes, 21 seconds left in that big hit from Hayden Argyle. And we're looking at 7-3 for the North with only 4 minutes, 50 seconds left. So they've killed half that penalty.
So yeah, hopefully Gareth's okay. It looked like a lower body injury.
Lower body, yeah. We'll see. Ankle maybe. We'll get more information on that. Big shout out to the Auckland. I know that the Southern team, Gel team, the Junior League team is playing up in Auckland this weekend. Best of luck to you boys. And I know that a lot of you guys will be interested in watching this game. Hopefully you're sitting down somewhere resting after your games today.
Mitchell Freer with the puck. Pass it around ice to Haynes. Haynes tried to tip it on there, but just quite whiffed on the shot. Dump it in deep, make Perry go out and play for it. Perry rings
McCaug it. McCaug chasing again and Harris ending up with a puck.
Pass it back to Mitchell Freer. Mitchell Freer will dump it in deep. Harrison McCaug going in on instruction by Luke Pickering. So he is a little bull terrier.
All year he's been doing that.
Luke Pickering now putting some pressure on the North, and I'll let him skate it out. Blake Jackson, who's probably one of the first hockey player in New Zealand I saw with that real hockey player smile, missing half his teeth. Now a puck with the South. Pass ahead to Luke Pickering. What can Luke Pickering do? Held up on the blue line. Shot there by Mitchell Freer. Bradley Axe tried to redirect it. Couldn't quite get enough of it though. Now Remy Sandoy going back the other way. Drops it off.
5 minutes of penalty, or with still a minute left, but 4 minutes of that penalty, and there's only been a few half shots on Matt Schwartz by that North Island.
Well, I think the dynamic definitely changes on a 5 minute penalty, because you're kind of, with a 2 minute, you're like, we've got 2 minutes to kill, and especially when your scores are 7-3, so you've got that four goal deficit. With 5 minutes, you're like, we can't sit on this, we're going to have to put the attack in. We've seen Harrison McCarg, we've seen Paris Hyde. Sort of
hunting,
putting pressure on, and not letting the North set up.
having a strong defense. Pass in front of that net, no one there to pick that up.
Tripped ahead there by Joe Orr.
We're down to the last 30 seconds in that big 5 minute penalty.
Andrew Hay picks up the puck.
Big dog,
by Ian
no
Watermaker.
One there.
Now Chris Eden with the puck now. What can Chris do from this position? Chris, got
Eden's
a lot of pressure on there.
He's dangerous in that corner.
Well, I think Chris Eden's been in the top 10 goal scorers in NZIHL every season he's played. So you don't want to leave him with too much of the puck. Try to clear it there.
That penalty is over.
Great job there by the South team. Basically killing a 7 minute penalty with that. 2 minutes backed onto the five.
Look at this.
Out in front. Shot. Goal!
Look at this. Unbelievable. The hole, the stick handle hole, goalie drop like a sack of broken hammers. And it was an easy shot, but he was left unguarded.
Yeah, that was Callum Burns there. And really surprised, like I was just saying, when that goal was scored, it was almost 7 minutes of penalty kill. Because we had the 2 minutes on Burr.
Those boys
straight away
tired.
Into that, and they come away and score that goal. So now we've had a...
So once again, that momentum happening. Remember I said that last time, but killing two penalties, no goals scored, and getting a goal shortly after. My goodness, we could be in for a very, very tidy third period. Nothing's over.
But you're right. For the North, they should have had the legs, and they just left Callum Burns out all alone there.
Unguarded. I think what happened is Hyde came on and made a bit of noise, and they gravitated to him in the high slot, leaving Burnsy low.
Puck coming out here. Paris Hyde can't pick it up, but he puts on pressure. Blake Jackson's going to have to make a big play here. Big hit there by Paris Hyde. Now the puck there, big hit. Big hits being thrown all around. Paris Hyde, big hit on Blake Jackson. Shot saved by Rick Perry.
Those are three of the biggest hits I've seen all night, perhaps all weekend. Just, they are going to have to replace these boards. My goodness, huge hits.
That was a 3-for-1 special.
Yeah, it was. Very entertaining. The crowd loved it. They're all clean, absolutely clean. And unless you got your leg in the wrong place, you're well padded, it's no big deal.
Just shot there by Lachlan Freer, just right into the chest of Rick Parry. So we have another face-off.
So we got the brothers too. We got the McCoggs and the Freers out there together, the Queenstown quartet.
Scrum there, Max McCogg still with it. Max drops it back, Burnsy shoots in front, bobbling puck, picked up there by Sandoy. Sandoy, another big hit there. Puck goes ahead, now we've got Vortnov all alone. Vortnov on Schwartz, big save.
Schwartz pulls it off! Another great save!
Schwartz there coming up big time, because you don't want the North to get another goal there. And that was all alone. The North had a great opportunity there. Now Sandoy got a bit worried. He started looking in our direction like he was going to clear that puck straight into
maybe
us.
Maybe we've ticked him off or something.
Pretty sure he can't hear us, can he, Dave? Now good pressure here by the South. Can they pick up another one before the end of the period? 30 seconds remaining.
30 seconds in. Left
Burnsy,
in this.
The Hyde. Big pressure there by Andrew Hay. Luke Pickering skates it out. What can Luke do? Luke tries to find Mitchell Freer. Mitchell Freer just overskating it there. Freer back to Hyde. Hyde puts it in front.
Rolling puck in front.
Now we've got an opportunity for Jeremy Chai. Mitchell Freer with the defense. Great defensive play. Draws the penalty, but made the heads up play.
Yeah,
that's
a
smart. The penalties you saw before were not smart. That was a smart penalty.
Yeah. And with only 10 seconds left in this period, very action packed period. We're looking at a penalty. I think it's
Mitchell Freer. Slash.
Yeah, just sort of a safety thing, trying to interfere with him before he got the shot away, and Schwartz pulled it off, so it worked. But now they've got to kill 2 minutes.
Now, I'm not one for conspiracy theories, Dave, but that referee Peter Hacks is from the North Island, and I don't think I've seen the North Island.
Now you're talking fighting words there, Aaron.
No, Peter's a great referee. I would never accuse him of bias.
You've got Peter. And we've got Aaron Chisholm on lines and
Braden O'Loughlin
as well on lines.
So that's the end of the second period. The Northern Whiptails leading 7-4. The South managed to sort of claw themselves back into the game there, while letting themselves out of the game at the same time.
The Eagle Claw clawing themselves out, yeah. My goodness, you guys, stay tuned for this third period. This is going to be a real heated session. I'm Dave Dubnyk.
I'm Aaron Bryan.
We'll see you in a minute. To the third period here at the Queenstown Arena. I'm Dave Dubnyk.
I'm Aaron Bryant, and we're in for an action-packed third period. And we've got a bit of injury news, Dave.
Go for it, Aaron.
So the North Island, unfortunately, have lost Aaron Henderson for the game with a concussion. That was that check in the corner by Hayden Argyle. And Gareth McLeish, I think he's a bit tentative. He was icing his knee up. He hadn't taken off his uniform yet, so we may see him back. I think he'd be very tentative and, as you said, underpowered at best.
Yes, we're looking at that penalty. A little reminder that right at the end of that second period, Mitchell Freer taking that slashing penalty, but I understand there's more to that.
Well, I think after that penalty, there must have been back chat. We didn't see it, but he's got a 10-minute misconduct as well.
So, once again, Stampede. Once again, South Island. Whoops! South Island, the Eagles are down one player starting the third period. So it's a 5-on-4 start of the third, 7-4 for the Stingrays.
Just a reminder, the South did win that penalty period, that last one, 4-3. So let's see if they can start it off with a bang. Puck goes behind the net there with number 13 for the North, Andrew Hay. Hey, looking up ice, seeing what he can find. Finds him, Lawrence. Lawrence only manages to pick off Eden though. Hyde. Hyde passes to Eden. Can't quite get that shot off though. Puck comes out for the North here. Atwell passes across ice to Chalice. Chalice goes into the corner. Pressure by Haynes though. Chalice just backed off there. It looked like he didn't want to get hit. Puck goes the other direction though. Eden. Just let Henderson, Lawrence, settle it behind the net. Hyde jumps in though, puts some pressure on. Hyde's the puck up in the corner there, manages to kill some time. South Island team are trying to let their teammates know that a number 18 for the North is just dangling around back behind the defense. Chalice dumps it in. Hyde. Haynes misses the puck completely, looked to clear it, couldn't do so. Now the puck to Hyde. Hyde now with a good opportunity. Hyde skates it in. Blake Jackson with the defense. Hyde shoots.
Boys, oh my goodness. There's no place like home. Hyde putting that puck. It was all soft, but well orchestrated. Beautiful shorthanded goal early in the third. Oh my goodness. 7-5. Aaron.
We got game on.
Game on. Now, we can't take anything away from this North Island. They had great pressure, great putting it into that South Island zone, but just kicked out.
That was a great one-on-one battle there with Hyde and Jackson. Jackson made some good moves, but Hyde was just one move ahead of him, managed to get around and slide that puck past Rick Parry.
Let's see how we go.
Got a nice little sliding run there by number 3 for the North, Nick Craig. Loses a glove for his trouble. He's going to come out, see if he can score one glove. George Kosler tries to clear the zone, held in there by Chai.
Fantastic stick work by Kosler. Amazing, great moves.
Wanamaker now with the puck behind the net. Wanamaker looks up ice, looks for his options, tries to find Burns, can't do so. Puck goes ahead, we've got icing. But I think that should have been a...
Yeah, I guess that penalty was over, so that is icing. They were both full strength. That was my confusion, too, there. I thought they were still down on the player, but once again, South Island able to kill a penalty and get a goal.
Get a goal.
Maybe they should spend more time. Don't say that, David. You'll be in trouble.
Well, you could say that, Dave, but I don't know if they can possibly spend more time in the box. Yeah. They've got it pretty packed up there pretty often. Puck comes back there. Shot from the point. Good block there by number three, Joe Orr. He's taking that hard. He's going to coming off there very gingerly on that ankle. Joe Orr made a great block there because that was a good shot there by the North, but just looking a bit tentative on his ankle there. Putting his ankle on the line.
On the line, yes. A few injuries tonight.
North Island now tries to skate it past. Good defense there, though, by number two, Bert Haynes. Haynes with the puck. Haynes looks up ice. Going to skate it out himself. Passes ahead. And only manages to pick off number two for the North, Jamie Lawrence. Nice move there by Haynes. Manages to get past the hip check. Shot by Harrison McCarr. Goes wide. Shot by Haynes. Hits the side of the net. Slowly getting closer, edging in there. Now puck comes out. True can't hold it in. Now got offside. Atwell's going to skate it in. Atwell off the puck. Atwell. Nice little backhand and move there. Just goes wide of the net. True with the puck. True passes it up ice. Picks up Max McCarg. Max McCarg with the puck. Max McCarg drops it back there for number 10 for the South. Lachlan Freer. McCarg. Looks for a teammate, can't find one, manages to pick off someone from the North. Henderson, maybe, not Henderson. Sean Harrison. Sean Harrison, still got the puck now. Goes for the wraparound. Good big stick save there by Matt Schwartz. True.
Well, Schwartz, he won't get fooled on that wraparound. Well tucked. He had his pad tucked nicely against the post and his stick involved as well.
Eden heading down into the zone. Eden with the puck. What can Eden do here? Eden skates in. Tries to chip it over the pad of Rick Parry. Can't do so. Now the North has skated out through Jordan Chalice. Jordan Chalice coming down into the zone. Going to put a shot from the point. Rough save by Matt Schwartz. And Remy Sandoy gets a bit of a push into the boards for his trouble. Gives Bradley Epps a little bit of a face wash there.
Just all smiles. It's just all hockey there. Just both teams making sure the puck is under control by Matt and that there wasn't a loose puck. Those rebounds can cost you.
North wins the draw. Shot shoots wide. Schwartz just bats it back behind the net. South Island players tripping over each other. Haynes. Haynes will clear it into the corner for Eden. Eden ahead to Hyde. Hyde now with the puck. Hyde's got options. Hyde skates it himself. Hyde's going to do it alone. Shoots, goes wide.
Back to the point. Loses it out.
Back drop Haynes. Back. Nice little interplay there between number 21, Tom Tappan and Bert Haynes. Deep in the North. Jeremy Chai now loses control of it. Hyde with the puck. Hyde passes to Eden. Eden with the shot. Shoots wide. Nice little evasive move there by Bert Haynes. Gets around that hip check. Dumped in there by number 22.
Offside. Offside. Now I'm wondering, you know, the South Island having both finalists in the National League competition, whether there's a battle fitness because they just played last weekend and many of the other players have rested for longer than that, whether or not that will come into play or...
That's definitely a factor. No, I mean, there's two options, right? Either they're tired from... Oh, nice deflection there. Almost went through.
Shot in front! Oh, my... Sorry.
Cameron True ribbons around the boards. Big hit there by Blake Jackson right in front of us. Puck comes into the south zone. Taken out there by True. True with the puck. True skates it in. Can't quite get it right into the zone. Lawrence looks up ice. finds Atwell. Atwell tries to skate it in, can't do so. Luke Pickering with the puck. Luke tries to find a teammate on the wing. No one there. Puck falls here. We've got it offside. What you were saying, Dave, about the fitness, I was wondering if there's two factors. Either you could say they'll tire out, or the North might not have that battle-heartedness.
Yeah,
they've
just
been off for a while. Having some, I don't know what you do in the North Island, drink your chai lattes on the beach, or what do you
North
do?
North Island stuff, I don't know. What do you do? Golfing, for sure.
Maybe
probably golfing.
Golfing
weather.
Fishing, sailing.
Sailing
City
and fishing.
Of Sails,
City
isn't
of
it?
Sails, yes. We're skiing here as we have the Winter Games happening.
And Wanamaker puts a shot in, goes wide. Puck comes out. Nice little shot there. Schwartzy just covers up.
Fantastic. Schwartzy not doing anything real spectacular with that. Just covering up, slowing things down. Knows that his boys can take the face off and set things up. Giving our boys also, sorry, giving the South Island, I'm showing my feathers. giving the South Island a chance to have a line change as
Your
well.
My feathers are showing, Dave.
My feathers are showing.
Oh, you got the South here with opportunity. Number 18, Bradley out. Chips ahead. Eden now. Eden with backhand. That's behind the net. Eden comes around from behind the net. Backhand. Justin Brunt. Oh, my goodness.
That was great, a juicy one sitting there. Open net.
Apologies to the North Island player. I didn't see your number. There was great defense there. Just ripping it off the line.
Spectacular defense. End to end hockey.
Whoa, oh! Good tag team, man.
The old sandwich. We'll have a North Island sandwich hold the mayo there. Good heavens.
Paris hiding his zone, shoots wide. Barrett Haynes on the point.
Perry getting peppered at the moment. Perry. Wanting to control that puck. North Island needing to clear that out. Doing a great job.
Now the puck with Chalice. Chalice tries to clear the zone, only can find True on the blue line. Blue line dumps it into the corner. Now Chai with the puck. Chai with an opportunity coming the other way. Gets around Haynes. Shoots, scores!
The five-hole special. That was a fantastic rally of events. Great turnaround for the North Island. Fantastic skating it in. That was like the first period stuff where all the action happening against the North, battering, and then they just break it out and concentrate on their control. Chai, great single-handedly stick handles through and beats Schwartz, I believe, between the legs. We're looking at 8-5 with 12 minutes, 52 seconds left in this third and final period.
Now is a bit of a chunk of the armor or the attack of the South. They're sort of getting back into that game. Just a little bit harder now.
This will rally the North Island.
Lachlan Freer dumps across the ice. Max McCarrick's going to skate in deep. Blake Jackson rings it around. I only find Lachlan Freer. Max McCarrick puts it in front. No one from the South there. Tom Tappan pass across the ice to Ian Wanamaker. Ian Wanamaker with the puck. Wanamaker's going to chip it in. Bouncing puck there for Parry. Plays it to his North Island teammate, number 3, Nick Craig. Now we've got the North skating it out. Jamie Lawrence. Jamie Lawrence with the puck. Stopped there by the glove of Ian Wanamaker. Big save by Schwartzy. That was a dangerous move by Wanamaker.
Yep.
Actually left it there for the North Island player.
He didn't make a full stop of it, leaving it there just like a ripe grapefruit to be picked. Schwartzy had to come quite far out to close off all the angles on that shot. That was a great save. Great pursuit by the North Island and great save by Matt Schwartz. Face off to the left of Matt with 11 minutes, 57 seconds in the third.
Puck sitting there for True. True tries to find Eden, can't do so. Epps is going to chase it in deep. Nice little play there by Rick Parry. Just held it there. Chipped it back past Epps, who's charging in. Hyde loses control of the puck to True. True looks for that long stretch pass, can't pick it up though. Vortnov now, Vortnov's going to skate it in the zone. Vortnov with an opportunity, pass it across. Goal scored by number 9, Kyle Johnson.
Some fantastic passing on that North Island. Just you didn't think anything was going to come of it, but they got the tape to take, st- stick-to-stick passing when they needed it. And slips it past Matt Schwartz.
There's not a lot more Matt could do on that one. It was a, he had the shooter
covered. And, you know, you can't take everybody. There's a quick transition in that play, which caught the South Island on the back foot.
So with that, the North goes back out to a four-goal lead. One of the other things is all the penalties the South have been taking. I mean, you talked about the both finalists last week, but they've been playing shorthanded for a majority of this game.
They could be very tired, you're right. The loss of Mitchell Freer, I believe, still, you know, that's a, he's a handy player. That'll be...
Puck in the corner there, tries to get it onto the middle, can't do so. No one wants the puck now. Skating in there, Tom Tappan puts it in front, shot, shoot, saved by Rick Perry.
Amazing save. Rick Perry, big ups for him there. Closed it off, shut it down. Things like that also slow down the momentum and give a boost to the North Island, which they don't really need, but they
don't really need a boost right now. If they go too much higher, they'll go through this low ceiling here in Queenstown.
Yes, the ceiling needs to be lifted, but fantastic. It's great to hear the North Island cheering, people cheering for that North Island squad as well. Shot in front. Great save again through a clutter of legs.
Nicely played there by the North Island. Spinorama move there by Tyler Rooney. Atwell dumps it behind for Sandoy. Rooney in front, Sandoy behind the net. Sandoy, shot there. Saved by Schwartz.
Schwartz just shutting down that momentum that the North Island had. Fantastic work by Sandoy.
Well, you were mentioning those ski fields before, Dave. I think a lot of North Islanders come down for a bit of a ski weekend and things like that. So there might be a few of them snuck into the crowd tonight.
Yes.
Back in the corner. But South come away with it. Max McCarg's going to skate hard after this puck. Sorry, Harrison McCarg. Mucho McCarg, too many of them. Now Harrison at the puck. Max shoots, save.
Yeah.
There's too many McCargs out there. I'm not sure which one's which.
Yeah, Freer's McCarg.
And the McCarg brothers go to the same hairdresser.
You know, this is a fantastic game of hockey. Big score, big hits, and great skating. Considering these boys haven't played together for all that long.
Puck in front. Ian Wanamaker now. Wanamaker shoots. A lot of deflections put on it by the South there, but Rick Parry managed to hold it. Wanamaker now. Wanamaker with a shot. Attempt. No. Pass. Shoot. Glove save by Rick Parry.
There was some great little cycling happening there. Great pass back to the point. Rick Parry, amazing saves.
He's not been an ice black goaltender for the last couple of years for no reason. He also played in France. He's one of the first New Zealand players to have a professional, semi-professional contract.
Très bien.
Playing for Sergei just out of Paris.
Wonderful.
Chris Eden now with the puck. Eden shoots. Connection. Puck
big rebound.
Wanamaker. The corner. Eden dumps it off. Can't do so. Dumped in deep by the North. Whoever icing. Yeah, so that move by Rick DeFrance was facilitated by Kevin O'Roll. He watches a lot of our games. He came over, was assistant coach for the Dunedin Thunder for a year. And after Rick went, Paris Hyde actually followed him the year after and played a season there.
Wow.
It might have been the other way around. I get them muddled up. They both played at Sergei. Sergei Jokers. North Island being told to change your centre. Possibly that one didn't put deodorant on this morning.
Yes.
Shot there. But Parry just gobbles that one up.
He's just being peppered at the moment, but we can't find any loose spots on him.
What he's doing quite well is eating those rebounds in, so he's not giving an opportunity.
I've noticed that, yeah.
And it's killing time. South will put a shot on. North Island now with the puck. Try to pass it out of their own zone. Sandoy can't get it out. Now we've got a nice pass to Vortnov. Vortnov chasing the puck. Haynes. Sandoy picks it up. Sandoy dumps it in deep. Bert Haynes going to skate it out. Tries to chip it past Callum Burns. Can't do so. Cameron True will go back there. Good pressure by number 19. Dropped off by Dvortnov. Puck in front. Shot by Blake Jackson. Blocked there by Joe Orr. So that ankle's back healthy again. He's out
Must
there
be.
Again.
Yes, that was nicely broken up by Bert Haynes. That was a great pass in front North Island had. Great combination happening. Vortnov passing in front, but Bert Haynes dumps it out over the blue line.
Vortnov now with the puck. Just sort of whiffs on that pass. Doesn't get it hard, and then South managed to win it back. Then quickly give it up to the North. Ian Wanamaker now off the puck. Wanamaker to Eden. Wanamaker, a good goal scorer for the Icebacks. Wanamaker in front, puts that shot on. Puck ahead now. Atwell with the puck. Skates it in deep. Paris Hyde trying to cut. Nice little pick there by number 22, Tom Tappan. That was going right in front. Michael Atwell dump it in deep. This is that high bouncing lob. It's always a good move because it gives your players time to get in there. Now the South will skate it down deep. Jackson Lane. Bert Haynes will skate back. No icing on the call. Haynes got a lot of time and space now. He'll skate out himself. Skates across the red line. Skates across the blue line. Gets in deep. Skates past the other red line.
In front of the net. And no one there.
Remy Sandoy falling prey to that nifty blue line, tripping over it. Bert Haynes dumps it around the boards to True. Kept in there by number 8 for the North Island. Remy Sandoy.
The puck is still moving, very slowly, but it is. Kept in by that North Island. Great pursuit.
Bert Haynes now off the puck. Bert's looking for an open player. Eden can't quite pick it up though. North now with the puck. North just playing with the puck there. They don't really have to do much. They've got that 4-goal lead. They can just kill time. Eden now. Eden tries to skate it in. Eden shoots, blocked there. Nice move by Max McCarg. Puck still in front, saved by Rick Parry. Max McCarg passes it out. Shot by Wanamaker. High deflection. Goes behind the net. They've got a penalty coming up.
Oh.
High sticking.
High sticking. Unfortunate. Momentum was going in that, mind you, in saying that, I was going to say the momentum was in South Island just because it was in the North Island region, but Rick Perry just bang, bang, bang. Save after save after save.
The 6 minutes remaining.
Who's in the box?
Number 7 for the South, Chris Eden. Puck comes out.
There
Blake
it is.
Agent can't control Callum. It. Callum Burns going after it. Hard. Callum Burns with the puck. Callum Burns shoots. Score!
Short-handed once again. He puts on the burners. Callum Burns. Snipers one in.
You were saying before, Dave, that maybe the South should spend more time short-handed. And the score is short-handed.
I've cursed them.
Callum Burns, of course, went to the Junior Winter Olympics skills competition.
That's right, he did.
Fourth or fifth, I think, a couple of years ago. I think the next iteration is just coming up, actually.
You know, we got Pickering out of Wauketip. We got Freer out of Wauketip. We got Burns out of Wauketip. And we got True. So, all Queenstown boys, originally. Pride of the South, yeah.
Fortnov now with the puck. Fortnov skates it in. Drops it off. Shot by Lawrence. Shot again by Lawrence. Chalice now with the puck. Chalice shoots across the ice. Wasn't really a shot. Was looking for that pass. Chipped out there by the South. Good pressure by Pickering. We're going to see a late charge here in the last 5 minutes by the South. Mitchell Freer with the puck. Mitchell Freer, good pressure there by Jamie Lawrence. Chris Eating, Paris Hyde can't get control of it. Number three for the North. Fizikos, shot! Put everything on that shot, including the gravy. Just couldn't quite put it on target.
Here it is.
Now an opportunity for Bradley Epps. Bradley Epps, shot!
Goal! Whoa, my goodness! Unbelievable! Short-handed goal. Look at, he's doing the eagle. He's doing the eagle.
Mama
the Epps, big slap.
Zoe Epps is watching from Sunny Tauranga. She'll be proud to see young Bradley score a goal like that. Second time the North have been caught out like that. They sort of must be putting too many guys forward. And Leonard South, because these gun guys have got the afterburners. Callum Burns, then Bradley Epps. So just skate in behind them. Get those opportunities. Hold on to your hats. We're back to a two-goal lead
for the North Island. Normally we'd say, well, that's it, folks. You know, only 5 minutes left, 4 minutes left in this game. But anything can happen, as we know.
Paris Hyde now with the puck. Paris Hyde gets around Bortnov. Paris Hyde. Now got a delay.
We've got a delay penalty. Schwartzy coming off, piling another player on the bench. Off the bench.
Put in front, picked up by the North, and we'll have a penalty. First penalty of the game.
No, I think earlier there was another penalty, but we'll definitely be able to see how they go.
So there'll be 28 seconds, 4-on-4.
Big shout out to the Haynes family. I know you'll be watching. Grandma Haynes, you're always watching, and we love your patronage up north there.
Mitchell Freer trying to indicate for one more to come out. Not realizing there's still 28 seconds on the Chris Eden one.
So there's
pretty hard for him to realize that, given they've scored two goals.
Yes. Yeah. Why would you worry, Mitchell? 4-on-4, so it's only 15 seconds left in that penalty to the South.
Tried to get it in the zone. Only managed to pick up Paris Hyde. Hyde skates around 1-2. Puck picked up there by the North. Skating out by Atwell now. Pressure by Hyde. Mitchell Freer is going to put pressure on Blake Jackson. Blake Jackson turns just in time to see Freer coming up behind him. Puck back to Haynes. Now we're 5-on-4 for the South. What can they do with this power play? Eden skates it in, drops it off for Hyde. Hyde shoots. Blake Jackson dumped in deep by the North. Matt Schwartz just leaves the puck there for Luke Pickering. Luke Pickering goes behind his net, passes to Bert Haynes. Haynes passes across ice to Freer. Can't pick it up though. Chai, pass back. Freer, North. Big save there by Matt Schwartz. North, South Island just need to slow down a little here. Just get a bit excited getting out of their zone. Can't quite control it. That was almost my shins. Bert Haynes with the puck. North Island doing great on the penalty kill here. Bert Haynes going to skate it in himself. Haynes looks for the options. Haynes puts a shot. Nice little deflection there. North Island defender stopped it. Almost in a dangerous position. Thought he was better off letting it go right through to Rick Parry. Shot by Eden. Saved by Parry. Rick Pickering with the puck. Drops it behind him. Eden now. What can Eden do? Eden skates in. Shoots. Saved by Parry. Still rebound going around there. Now Jeremy Chai is going to skate it out. 11 seconds remaining on the penalty. Picked up there by Callum Burns. Burns passed to Eden. Eden drops it off for number 10.
There is that tape-to-tape passing that they're needing. They've been needing all game.
Eden now with opportunity. Shoots. Goes high behind the net. That's right, Dave. Getting that passing a lot more crisp now. Lachlan Freer drops it off. Picked up by Burns. Burns drops it behind him. No one there, unfortunately. Picked up by number 13 for the North.
That penalty's gone now. 2 minutes left in this game.
Now got Vortnov with an opportunity. Vortnov all alone. Icing.
Icing is called, but in the hybrid icing, I'm wondering if that was a wise call or not.
No, I think the North might have a case there. You just see where they're going to play this face-off. They're going to play it in the center.
Remy's just already indicating it's a center ice drop. Don't bother arguing. Don't get angry. It's a mistake. Drop the puck. Let's play hockey.
So the entire South Island bench is up on their feet now.
Wow, these fans have been the opportunity to watch a spectacular hockey game from the best hockey players in New Zealand. That's what you got to say.
And Wanamaker tries to get a puck. Good pressure there by the North Island, though. Lawrence, shot, goes wide. Now we've got number 12 for the South Island. Chips it in deep. Rick Perry with a stick and his glove and slow play down.
1 minute 40. Matt Schwartz is looking at the bench. He'll probably get a nod. Big thanks and big shout out.
Timeout here.
Oh, timeout called. Great opportunity to thank everybody involved in this. You know, all those volunteers all season long. Huge thank you. Security, goal judges, timekeepers, penalty box people, announcers, everybody. It's all off their own bat. Big thank you, not only here in Queenstown, but a big thank you, Dunedin, Christchurch, and Auckland as well. This can't happen without your patronage. And, of course, you people viewing tonight, big thank you as well.
So we just see after that timeout, Matt Schwartz is going to stay on the bench because the face-off's down in the north zone. So now pull the goalie and look for that first goal to try and get within one. So make or break time. Minute 40, probably about the right time to do it.
Yeah, that's a lifetime in hockey.
Got to win the draw first.
Yes, unlucky there.
Cut goes around to Pickering. Pickering with it. Pickering needs to control it here. North Island falls for him. South managed to recover. Dump it in deep. Need to control it. Shot here. Shoots wide. Icing.
Great.
A little interplay there by Jeremy Chai and Bert Haynes. Having a little conversation.
Both talking to the linesman as well. So face off deep in that northern zone.
See if they can win the face off from this side.
To the right of Perry.
Pickering to take it. Pickering can't win the draw, but the north south put enough pressure on. Puck comes back. Mitchell Frey will pick it up. South have got six skaters out there. Eden. Eden with the puck. What can Eden do with it? Eden skates it up. Skates past one, falls over though. Now that he's north on, Parasite did well there to keep control of the puck. Puck drops, nice for Chai. Good block here by Bert Haynes. Could be a goaltender in another life.
Oh, goaltending Bert Haynes.
Mitchell Frere in the zone, shoots. Can't get it in though. Trying to get it deep into that zone. 42 seconds remaining, what can they do? North with the puck again, Chalice shoots. Saved by Bert Haynes. I think he's overheard his hand there. Had to drop his glove. Puck dropped off. Pickering. 28 seconds remaining. You have to say it's probably a bridge too far now. Haynes dumps it in deep. Hits that ceiling. Gets a whistle.
That'll be in the offside circle. To the right of Rick Perry with only 19 seconds left. Oh my goodness. What a spectacular game. North Island came in. Getting quick goals, stacking up the goals. South Island clawing their way back. Yeah, you got to say that all those penalties added up at the end of the game, and we said that might happen. Take away those goals scored on penalties and on power plays, and we would have had a different result.
True with the puck. True passes in deep. South fighting spirit, fight right to the end here.
10 seconds.
North Island did a great job of tying it up. Got a little bit of rough and tumble in the corner. Puck comes out.
That's it. That ends
the game, folks. North Island, after a three-year drought, so we said it was 3-all. The North Island won the first three of the State of Origins, and then the South Island have been on a three-year winning streak. So just like the Red Devils, they couldn't make it 4 in a row.
Yes, interesting.
So three is the magic number in this.
I think so. I think that's the same in politics. winning three elections and then can't seem to win the fourth, if I'm not mistaken. But That was a spectacular game of hockey.
It was a really great game of hockey. It's great to see the New Zealand talent out there. And, you know, there's been a lot of talk about, you know, imports, should we have and should we not? But I think, like, in games like tonight, we can see how it develops the talent in New Zealand. This is only New Zealand players out there, guys. It's just so you remember, everyone at home, it's only New Zealand players out there. And we saw a great game of hockey, great speed, great shots, some good goaltending at both ends of the ice.
Fantastic to see. From this will be chosen that final Ice Black team squad. And, you know, it's been a whole season for me of commentating. Thank you very much, Aaron. It's spectacular to have you here this evening. You know, come all the way from Australia just to participate in this. It's amazing. Big shout out, big thank you to Casey Lucas, who worked with me all year on announcing. And, you know, she's just doing it off her own bat. And Jess Brown, and Logan, Cliff Baker, Felicity, all those people that helped make this broadcast work for you people out there. We appreciate all your comments.
4 years ago, we had that first final in Queenstown.
That's right.
We crowdfunded the final. We raised $2,000, I believe. And we got, we had a satellite link up. We didn't have, I mean, it's amazing to watch the progression of not only the league, but the broadcast. And as you say, you've thanked about 80 people there. When we did it the first time, it was me, you, and Jez Brown. That was it.
Yeah.
That was the team.
Yeah.
Now we've got things like scorebugs, the clock, and replays.
We're developing a fan base, from what I understand. We're developing a fan base all around New Zealand, but also around the world. Not us, but the hockey. We're just
the
mouthpiece.
There's a lot of hockey tragics in Canada.
Yeah.
You know, it's like,
you know,
there's no hockey on.
Exactly.
What are we
going to
do?
All summer, what are we going to do? Late at night, I can't sleep. There's no hockey. I'm going to watch a hockey game in New Zealand. And
yeah.
So thank you to all you people that are, doing that, just supporting us. And who knows where this will end up. Opportunities next year. Just keep watching, keep supporting us.
So we've got the glass shield being presented, which is the trophy. The glass shield named after, of course, the Glass family. So we've got Graham Glass and Simon. Graham Glass was in the first Ice Blacks team. Simon was a captain of the Ice Blacks for many years. I believe he played last night.
He played last night, yes. He had a big smile on his face.
And amazingly, he managed to get up this morning.
Yes. So the presentation of a shield from Graham Glass to Andy Hay, the captain of the North Island, holding it up.
I might need Claire's help on this one, but I believe this is the fourth time Andy Hay's lifted that shield, because I think he's been the captain every year for the North Island.
Interesting. Photos being taken. Big cheers from on for the South Island team as well. Well, end of the season, bit teary. Bit tired, but very happy with the results. I want to thank all you fans. My name is Dave Dubnik. Thanks for listening to the 2015 Hockey in New Zealand.
I'm Aaron Bryan, and thanks for having me back. Thanks, Dave. Thanks for having me. And big shout out to Jez, like Graham Glass mentioned. You guys at home, none of what you're watching would be possible without him. So that's it from us, and I'm signing off.